A woman took to Facebook to defend her $130 engagement ring. So the woman is Ariel Desiree McCray, and she took to Facebook just to defend this ring that she had from her fiance, she says is her best friend. And actually, the post went viral. It's been shared 50,000 times. Basically, what she says in the post, just a brief quote, and then we're gonna talk a little bit more about it. She says, quote, "We scrape and scrape to pay bills and put food in our bellies, but after almost 2 years of dating, we decided that we couldn't wait anymore, so we didn't." So they went to a Pandora jewelry and they pick out a ring set that she really likes and she thinks is great. I don't think that they were really thinking about the price tag here, but she liked the ring set. And as they go to check out, a sales associate apparently said, quote, "Y'all, can you believe that some men get these as engagement rings? How pathetic." And then this is where the story gets really sad, because Ariel explains, quote, "He already felt like a failure asking me again and again, are you sure you'll be happy with these? Are you sure this is okay? He was so upset at the idea of not making me happy enough and me not wanting to marry him because my rings didn't cost enough money or weren't flashy enough." She goes on to say, "It isn't the ring that matters. It is the love that goes into buying one that is." She was surprised at the response that she got over sharing this, you know, just an encounter that she had to Pandora Jewelry. I guess it was a momentous moment in her life. Quite a momentous moment, yeah, because she was getting engaged to her best friend. And she just wants people to know, you know, she's been interviewed by the Today Show. She just wants people to know, bottom line, people shouldn't have to go into debt for love. It's the love that's important. You can get married without rings. It's just material. And people have been, you know, really supporting her and also pointing out that the sales associate probably didn't intend on being rude. They might not have known that it was an engagement ring, probably just something said off the cuff. But it does bring up a larger discussion, Amir, about engagement rings. And beyond engagement rings, just jewelry that is given to significant others, etc. Should it have a monetary value? Does it mean more if it has a higher monetary value?
No. The whole concept of engagement rings, I think it's super outdated and just obsolete at this point. The whole point of it was, I think, back in the day, like getting an engagement ring, it's like paying a dowry to,
right,
you're putting in all of your resources into this one thing to show that like you've committed. I feel like nowadays, just the way society has changed, at least in America, it's like, why would you put all of your money in this thing right here?
Well, certainly not in this.
It's like our pride. Oh, yeah, certainly not in that. This is made out of black
diamond.
This is
like, I'm trying to dump you. That's a dumping.
But you know what I mean? Like, it's kind of crazy to waste all your, not even waste, maybe it's not waste, but to put your money.
Right, because some people wouldn't think of it as wasting their money.
Yeah, like, we live in a society now where both parties in a relationship normally work, and it's like you would want to put your money into something that's actually going to help your life, mm-hmm, as opposed to in a ring. And don't get me wrong, I'm when I get married, I'm still going to get a ring, but I get it. Like, why should you dedicate, like, what's the rule? Like, 1/3 of your income?
Yeah, it is something, it's 1/3 of your monthly paycheck, or it's something like 3 months paycheck.
That's crazy.
Something like that.
That's crazy.
I know.
We're like living paycheck to paycheck as it is, most people.
Yeah, I know.
And if you want to get married, I think most people will agree with this woman.
Yeah, I was surprised.
You don't need
that
to drop $8,000 on an engagement ring.
Yeah, I also think that it is about the sentiment. And this just goes with other jewelry as well, because I know that we've had friends who have given significant others jewelry, and maybe they'll get, you know, hints from the significant other, like, I want X jewelry, and you look at the price tag, and that's, oh, $3,000. Well, here's something that looks a lot like that for $300, and, you know, I still want to get her a nice Christmas gift. Why don't I just get this instead? And then it's like, oh, well, you didn't get the real thing. I don't know.
You could go on an amazing honeymoon for that money.
Yeah, to me, it's always been about
travel the world,
quality time and planning and really good meals, really good food. So I know that whenever I get engaged,
3,000 cheeseburgers,
so many burgers, except it'd have to be veggie burgers now.
Okay.
But anyway.
Are you a jewelry person? What do you think about this story?
I know that when I get engaged, I will be the one proposing and that I won't wear a ring. I would probably get a...
You're not going to wear a ring?
No. Not. I mean, when I'm married, I would wear a band, but I think when I'm engaged, I'll probably get like a tattoo or something to also signify something, not just because I like them,
yeah,
but...
Two birds with one stone.
Right. But I think that it was good that this woman spoke out and said that it doesn't matter what the monetary value is of the ring. It's the sentiment behind it. And think of now that they're saving that money on the ring, think of all the things that they can do together. Yeah. Think of how much richer their time will be together because they didn't spend it all on just a piece of jewelry. It's, you know, really it's just stones and rocks.
Yeah, I feel the same way almost. I feel the same way almost about a big wedding, which is something in my, like, culturally, like, I know I want to do that because we've been told all our lives that you need to have a wedding, a big one, but we've just reached a point economically and culturally where throwing that wedding, is it actually worth it? Is it worth paying tens of thousands of dollars for this wedding for one day? If it's gonna, like, you're spending all that money for that one day, and then what?
I don't know. I mean,
I know you're a big wedding person, right?
Well,
you told me something one time.
Don't know. I mean, I'm not married, so it's hard to say. But I do think that that there is an industry behind weddings, and there is a whole industry behind engagement rings.
I don't think normal Americans can just, like, afford it anymore.
But we're being sold that you have to. If you love this person, we see all these commercials. If you really love this person, then you'll get them X diamond from X store, or you'll spend this amount of money on this type of a honeymoon at this resort with them. Make it your own. Mm-hmm. I know that this isn't the same thing, but you know that Lizzie and I are driving to Alaska a year from now, basically, and that's our vacation that we're really looking forward to. We're going to be gone for about a month. But it's, you know, that's not a vacation that would be sold to us as far as being romantic. But you have to find what romance means to you and what love means to you. And it might not be $130, you know, engagement ring. It might be something really more exorbitant. You really want to spend that money, and that's okay.
Experience.
But you shouldn't shame people that don't subscribe to that system of beliefs. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, so let us know in the comment section below. Are we totally wrong? Do you want to buy us an engagement ring? Are you engaged? Tell us your story. I would like to read those. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel, and we'll see you next time on Pop Trigger.